Hello, Benedicte Olrik here, and thank you so much for subscribing to my website. And as promised, I'm going to send you weekly guidelines on how to build the fundamentals in your wardrobe, how to shop, and also how we're going to get the most of the items already in your wardrobe. So jeans, I believe, are definitely an essential basic that we have to have in your wardrobe. You will have, I know jeans is to find the right fit and pair, so that the right fit and cut for you and wash is can be quite daunting. So I'll just recommend trial and error, go out there, try lots on and find a pair that really suits you. I like, for me, I like sort of a higher waisted cut and a skinnier leg. That sort of come either down below the angle or just sit above the angle. I like a stretch denim, but not too much stretch, because you want to sort of make sure it keeps in shape. So sort of around 2 to 4% stretch at a maximum. Probably it's trying to tend to be more around 2%. I like that, and I also like a little bit of a lighter denim, not too thick. Again, just for comfort, and it feels nicer on your wearing them. In terms of wash, I highly recommend the wash is sort of a little bit lighter here in the front, but just sort of down to mid-knee, and then it sort of darkens up. It's not the best example, but with doing this, it's going to lengthen your leg and make you look slimmer, which we probably all would like to, regardless. The other thing, similar to the wash, make sure that the mid thigh here is a little bit darker. Black denim in a clean version, and what I mean about clean is that no distress, and it actually is black, it's not washed charcoal yet. And I believe it's a real, really must have in your wardrobe. You can always go to that if you sort of want to look nice and fresh and smart. You can dress it up with a ballet flat, one of your white t-shirts, and a jacket and a scarf, and wow, you have an outfit there. If you want to elevate it into evening, then put these on, your strappy sandals, and a silk camisole, a fitted black jacket, and your outfit is there. And now, white jeans. I know that creates a lot of fear when you're talking about white jeans, but I think they are also really an essential basic in your wardrobe. There's a lot of ways to look at the fit, so you can actually have a pair that looks really, really flattering on you, regardless of your size. These ones are actually quite distressed. Like normally, I also have just a plain one or a simple one, as I said before, or clean without distress, which look really nice. But I love my white jeans, and I think it's such a beautiful spring and summer look. You can always you can just wear it with your white, very, very washed t-shirt and a pair of flat sandals, and just roll up the length of the jeans a bit, and that looks like such a nice fresh summer look. You can also dress it up, put on your beautiful wedges, and have a looser multicolored silk caftan hanging over it, big gold earrings, and you're ready for a summer party. So in terms of how to shop for white jeans and getting something that's really flattering on you, then similar to what I did for my blue jeans, is that I like personally a higher waist, and the reason is that it tucks in nicely, and I think it's more flattering on my body type. But you'll just have to try what works for you. The other thing I'm really looking for is the thickness of the jean. I like them a little bit more thick, and still I like the stretch to be about 2%. And then what I also do for my white jeans, I go up a size. And the reason for that is that, not only because it's a summer thing, so if I'm going a little bit thicker, you also want to be more comfortable. But the main reason with the thickness of the denim and also going up a size is that you don't want it to be super tight on the back of your thigh. You don't want to have that sausage look. That's not very flattering. And also, they're just fall nicer as a denim. And also, the thickness also prevents for, you know, being see-through and maybe looking a little bit tacky or cheaper. My next item is denim skirts. Yes, I'm still in the jeans denim department. And I just want to say here, I'm not trying to discriminate against people who like shorts or cut-ups. If you like wearing that and you feel fantastic in them, please just either replace them with a denim skirt or add on to the denim skirts. I don't look very good in shorts, so I don't like them on me. So that's why I'm not showcasing them. But by all means, if you like them, please go ahead. They look really, really good on. Now, so again, I have quite a few. I'm just showing you one that's not distressed, just a little bit bigger, a little bit more sort of everyday, not too short, so you don't have to show your undies when you're sitting down. Now, the way I like my denim skirt is a slight, especially just the one that's not distressed, just a plain denim skirt. I like it a little bit A-shaped, not too fitted. And I do like a little bit of stretch for comfort. It is quite hard to find a denim skirt, I find, with stretch in it. So if you can't find it, that's fine, but maybe just make sure that it's comfortable to walk in and it sits nicely. And the stretch I recommend probably 1-2%, not a lot. If you are choosing a quite fitted one, I think it's better without stretch, because if it's really stretched, it can look like it's almost been sprayed on, and I don't think that's a very flattering look. And in denim skirt, I also do a white, and I think again that it's such a nice white. It's just white denim in summer and spring. It's just beautiful, and I love that sort of fresh.
If you have any comments, please, if you're on YouTube, please put them down here, or any questions, I will answer them as quickly as I can. The same thing if you're not on YouTube, but listening to this from the guidelines that I've sent to you via an email, please reply to my contact form that is on my website.